So today we're going to run through the different ways to start a firing using the Genesis controller. So first of all, it's good practice to always check to make sure what program you've got loaded into the controller. So we're going to press the edit button. Right now I've got a custom user program loaded. So if everything looks good, we can press the back button, get back to the home screen, and then we can go ahead and start the firing. So we press the start button. We've got the option to either start now, start later, or remote start. So first I'm going to do a start now. We enter the start code and press go, and the firing will begin. So first it's doing a quick check, and once the check's completed, it'll start the firing, and it'll read firing up here across the firing banner. So just give it a second. There we go. So now we know the firing's begun. So at any point in time, if you need to stop your firing, you can always press the stop button. So we're going to go ahead and hit stop, and we're back at the home screen. So the other options we've got, we can start later. So if we press start later, we have to enter our start code again and press go. And then we can enter a delay time up to 99 hours. So I'm going to put a delay time of 2 hours in and press save. So now the screen's changed here, and it's going to count down up at the top until the firing's to begin. So we're going to go ahead and hit stop again, take us back to the home screen. Now the other option for starting is to remote start. So we press remote start, enter our start code, press go, and you can see remote across the firing banner. Now that just arms the controller to be fired using the KISS system. So if we've completed that, we're going to go ahead and hit stop and take us back to the home screen. So that's the different ways we can start a program using the Genesis controller. Remember to check our website for updates, like us on Facebook, and sign up for our e-newsletter for more information and tips. Thanks!